Summit Advisory. I'm a senior, so class of 2016. Things I love to do, I like writing poems, I love listening to music, I love to smile, and I love to take selfies. This is an example. And I'm a very humble person, but very shy at first as well. Agenda, my icebreaker, academic reflection, my passion, really talk about my internship and project, and closure. I didn't really do my experience in the future, but I'll talk about it. My icebreaker, if you guys don't mind, you guys all have phones, so if you don't mind texting Anna Silva 844 to 2333, please.
You
guys
can trade it.
Let's see what you do.
Messaging.
What is it?
Silva 844.
Oh, I see.
What you got?
So when you guys are done, I want you to answer that question. What are your likes and dislikes about school? You don't have to click on the link, all you have to do is text once you get the link.
Yeah, just send another text.
Okay. My purpose, I want to show that special needs kids can learn the same exact way, just We learn differently, so can they. There's not much of a difference. All you have to do is be more hands-on instead of actual teaching on a board. My project, I'm working on a curriculum for a school and an outline of a school, so how the school will run and what type of teachers will be there, if there's doctors needed with these kids. My project development, I'm coming up with a curriculum. I'm actually going to my mentor tomorrow. She's going to look at some of the things I've been working on. Present the curriculum to the teachers and to my mentor. Small lesson with the kids. I think in like 3 to 4 weeks, I'm actually going to do a lesson with the kids for the vice principal at Rafael Hernandez. I'm excited. And it benefits myself because I get a real hands-on experience with the kids that I've been working with. This is type of the lesson plan that I've been working on. Like it describes what kids I have to work with, what type of autism they have or disabilities. So this is just a preview of how it looks, and it'll involve hands-on, like I said before. Instead of learning how to like write your name, they have to learn how to open a milk carton or hold a pencil or put up a straw. It's different than what we actually do here. My learning goals, I need to learn how to hand in my work on time. I'm very lazy, so I'm like doing homework. And get really better presentations. I think that's why they ask all of you to come here, because you know I'm working on that. And my self-assessment, by next exhibition I will have a little video of me teaching with the kids and my actual curriculum with the school. And that's it.
I wanted to hear more about how do you fix your issues of procrastination.
I want to have groups of people with me and go to schools to actually show them that these kids can learn the same way or a different way. They just need an opportunity to have that chance.
Thank you.
Questions?
Great. What motivated you to actually
wanted to do this?
Yeah, was it your cousin?
Yeah, my little cousin was born with Down syndrome 2 years ago, and I see he goes home, he goes to school, and they push him to a corner, and it's like, you shouldn't do that to a kid, especially if they need more help. So that's what got me really into it.
How could your new curriculum change the world?
So the school that I go to, their curriculum is more hands-on to the kids. Like when we get there, we sit them in breakfast and everything, and after breakfast, we separate them. We put them in like block area, crayon area, whatever area they want to go to that they pick, because you can't tell them what to do. So they pick, and then we go and teach them how to actually build blocks. Instead of sitting them on a chair, we do more activities. So it helps them understand the concept of building something, or you know, instead of my name is this, they understand the real concept of things. Miss A?
So in the lesson plan you said that you would teach them how to open like milk and stuff.
Yeah.
So would you say that your lessons have to mold kind of around teaching life lessons more so than typical academic stuff?
Yeah.
So to become a special education teacher, you have to go the same process as a regular teacher, or you take
it's the same concept, but you have to go to, I think, a 2-month program in order to become a special needs teacher. You have to actually work with kids for them to see how you go, something like that. But you go to the same process, you just have to have your teaching degree.
All right, how about some specific feedback? We'll start with the students. Good things that you saw, positives, and then things that you would like to add as suggestions.
Christopher.
you did a good job. The thing is that you kind of ran too late. So that's the only downside.
Raquel. I like how you explained everything and you knew what you were talking about. And he said, we need to slow down because right in the beginning, we're just rushing right through it.
Monty.
Take your time. R-U-L-A-A.
Or take 45 minutes.
Need extra time? 45 minutes is ejected.
This is coming from someone who talks for miles.
Well, I got two good things. I learned that if you don't have a scripted presenting, your presentation skills really impressed me. And I can tell that you are very passionate about teaching and becoming a leader because your concepts in your slideshows were outstanding. And something to work on was be patient with your presentation.
Alright, so positive feedback. You know, you're passionate about educating, special education, you know, things like that. And basically, a good thing was that you got out of your comfort zone, you know. And I guess, look at the size of this class, you know. And you presented in front of everybody, you did a good job, you know. And I guess, you know, it was like your first time or whatever, but it doesn't matter, you know. You use it as a learning experience. So for the next exhibition,
You had
an amazing presentation. I feel like you're one of those people that I would want to hear more from because you're not, you don't sometimes rant on like some people here, you know. But it's something like I would want to hear more from you. So if you were to elaborate on something, because I know, because of your innate skill of being really clear, you're not going to drag the concept. So it's something, if you did that, I feel like you would have sort of exposed your potential. If you did that.
Thank you, Eric, for taking shots.
What are you talking about?
A? Yeah. Just very quick, since everybody pretty much said I think you had a really good amount of information and it was all presented pretty clearly. Just pretty much what everyone said, slow down. I know you were nervous,
yeah.
But just take a breather and slow down and it's perfect. Really good. I love your passion. Very important.
Your presentation overall, I know you were nervous, you were running through it very, very quickly. I thought overall the presentation was well. It was very, 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 very short. So there's more areas you could have expanded on, such as discussing your academics, what you're doing to improve upon. You showed us in the beginning that you struggled in the beginning and could have just elaborated a little more on that. Everything else people kind of said. You didn't have your personal narrative or anything to discuss.
I don't like writing, so it's something I'm not.
Okay. Well, overall, I thought it was great. Your LTI summary was great to hear. I thought you did a good reflection on that. I think you need to work on when it came to the grade level focus and like the academics. But I thought you have a good plan in place of what you want to do. And I think John had brought it up. If you had put in there about your family member that has Down syndrome, that would have been great to have up there instead of us asking.
I'll just say like all of the kind of critical things were already said about slowing down, having more evidence, and making sure you hit all those points. But I'll point out that I think that the most solid part of your presentation was about your project and your internship. And so I think it's really clear that your passion is there and that you are working on a plan. You seem to be one of the students who has really got the plan underway, which is, it should be a positive. Like you have a lesson plan in place. Like I thought it was great that you had an actual lesson plan up there for us to see. Like a lot of students don't have those kind of background artifacts in their projects yet. So you should be proud of yourself for really having the project in place and starting to work on it. And so we can work on the presentation skills and all of that stuff, you know, for the next time. But I think you should be proud of yourself.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you guys.